Hello and welcome to today's video. This video is on how to test without requirements. It can happen that you are required to test an app and you are not given any requirement. This may happen if you join the project late and are required to do the testing, or it may happen that you are an external consultant working on the project and you are asked to do the testing just before the release. It is still possible to test an application without having any requirements. So let us see how we can do that. So first of all, each and every application has some basic properties, so we can test the basics. In this video, we are going to look at a demo web application that I have created and use the knowledge in this video to test that application. So let us see the application. So this is a demo web application and the title of this application is the Journey Planner. So basically all you do is you enter the distance to travel in miles, then you enter the average travel speed in miles per hour, then you can select how many hours you are going to be traveling every 24 hours, and then click on the calculate travel days button and it will give you what is the total number of travel days. So let us see how we can test this application because we don't have any requirements in front of us. So first thing we need to test is, does the app launch? So if it is a web application, you can open the URL in the browser and see if the application launches or not. The second thing you can test is, does the app accept user input? So there are a few elements in this application and let us test whether it accepts user input or not. So first we'll try to enter some distance to travel. So maybe we want to travel 100 miles. Then another entry we can make is for the average travel speed, so maybe 50 miles an hour. And then there is a drop down to select how many hours we want to travel every day. So maybe we want to just travel 2 hours. So yes, it is accepting the user input and this is what we can test. Next thing we can test is, does the state of the app change on giving the user input? So we have already entered some values and we have a couple of choices here. We can click the reset values button and our expectation is that everything will revert to its original value, or we can click on the calculate travel days button. So let us try both. So first let us click on the calculate travel days button and yes, it is showing some results. So yes, this state of the application is changing when we give the user input. Next, we can test the reset values button to see if the state of the application changes. So yes, it has reset the values. The next test we can do is, does each control in the app work? So here we have the controls. So obviously we are able to enter values in these controls and we are also able to operate the reset values and calculate travel days button, so it works. The next thing we can test is it possible to copy or paste data to and from the app? So let us say I want to travel 100 miles an hour and I just don't want to type the average speed as 100 miles an hour. So let me select this and copy and paste it in the speed. So copy and paste does work in this app. The next thing we can test is, does the app close? So all we need to do is to close the browser because it is a web-based app and we can test that also. Now the important thing to test in the app is the functionality. So here we can test, is it possible to perform the tasks promised by the app? Now since it is a journey planner and basically there is some help text also which explains it, but from reading the different labels and the different controls, it seems that we can give a total distance to travel in miles, and we can give our average travel speed also, and we can select how many hours we want to travel every day. So let us see if this works or not. So in order to do that, you can design the test data. So here I already have some test data designed. So first of all, we can test whether the inputs are validated by the app or not. So let us say that distance is expecting a numeric value. So instead of numeric value, we can give an alphanumeric value, some string. Same for speed, and we can select any number of travel hours per day, and our expectation is that it will give us an error. So let us test it out with this test data. So I'm going to put the distance as ABC, the travel speed as XYZ, and the hours to travel every 24 hours as 1, and click on the calculate travel days button, and it says please enter a valid distance to travel, please enter a valid average travel speed. So basically it does validate the input. Now let us keep the distance as alphanumeric but give a valid speed of 100 miles an hour and see if it still gives an error, because the distance to travel is invalid. So let us click on the calculate travel days button now, and yes, it says the distance to travel is invalid, so please enter a valid distance to travel. Now we can make the distance to travel as valid and the speed as invalid, some string. So let us say we have to travel 1000 miles but the average travel speed we give as some invalid value. So it does validate it. It says please enter a valid average travel speed. So in all these cases we did get the errors. Now let us try with invalid values which are numeric but they are negative. So let us say I put a distance of -100 miles. Now -100 miles is not a valid distance, and average travel speed according to the test data I'll put as -50, and click on the calculate travel days button, and yes, it does give an error message, which is what we expected. Now let us give valid values. So here what we are going to do is give the distance as 1000 miles and the speed as 100 miles an hour. So basically it's going to take 10 hours to cover a distance of 1000 miles traveling at a speed of 100 miles an hour, but we are going to be traveling only 1 hour per day. So since it is 1 hour per day, a total it's going to take 10 days in order to cover this distance. And what the app does is it basically rounds off to the next highest integer, because 10 whole days are going to be spent in traveling, because we are only traveling 1 hour per day. So let us give these values. So the first value is 1000 miles and our average travel speed is 100 miles an hour and going to travel only 1 hour every 24 hours. So it says the distance to travel is 1000 miles, which is what we entered. The average travel speed is 100 miles an hour, which is what we entered, and it's going to take 10 days. So this is also working fine. Next, we can give 1000 as the distance, 100 as the speed, and 8 travel hours every day. Now here what is going to happen is total covering 1000 miles at 100 miles an hour, it's going to take 10 hours, but since we are going to be traveling only 8 hours per day, so 800 miles will be covered in the first day and 200 miles in the second day. So it's going to take 1.25, or we are going to have to travel for 2 days, 800 miles in the first day and 200 miles in the second day. So let us test with this test data. So 1000 is already there, 100 is already there, and now we are going to travel 8 hours. So it does say total travel days is equal to 2 days. Now we can give the same test data, 1100, but we are going to put travel hours per day as 24. So it's going to be a non-stop kind of a travel. And click on calculate travel days. So it says 1 day, because total it's going to take only 10 hours, and because we are going to be traveling throughout, so it's going to be only 1 travel days, which is what we are expecting. Now let us give some other values, and let us give a shorter distance and a very high speed. So we have to travel 100 miles and traveling at a very high speed of 200 miles an hour, but going to only spend 1 hour traveling every day. And here what we are expecting is that it's going to take us only half an hour in order to complete the distance, because the speed is 200 miles an hour and we just have to travel 100 miles. So only 1 travel day is there. So let us test with this. So yes, it is 1 travel day. So similarly, we can test with the other test data values that we have designed based on our understanding, because we did not have any requirements. Let us also try with decimal values. So let us say the distance is 200.6 and we give speed as 22.5 miles an hour, and we are going to travel for 7 hours per day. So this basically is going to test the decimal values also. So total it's going to take 1.27 something days. So we are expecting 2 travel days here. So let us click on calculate travel days, and yes, it does say 2 travel days. So this is how we can test the functionality. Now it is also possible that your app has a help file or some demo available, and you can test your app with respect to the help file or the demo. So here we have some help text available. We can read this. So it says, this is a simple web application. You should enter the total distance to travel, the average travel speed, and the number of travel hours every day. Then click on the calculate travel days button. And it talks about the validation. If any data entered by you is incorrect, you will get an error message in red color. So let us say I put a distance of ABC and click on the calculate travel days button. Yes, I'm getting an error message in red color. If you click the reset values button, you will reset the distance to travel and average travel speed values to 0. So let me click on the reset values button, and yes, the values revert to 0. If the data you entered is correct, you will get the number of travel days in black color. So we can give 1000 miles traveling at a speed of 50 miles an hour. So it's going to take a total of 20 hours. So if we put 8 travel hours every 24 hours, it's going to take more than 2 days but less than 3 days. So it should show 3 days, which is what it shows. So this is how we can test the functionality based on our understanding of how the application works. The next thing we can test is the user interface. So we can test, does each control have a consistent look and feel? So let us look at the text boxes. So the text boxes font size and the drop down font size seem to be the same. The other text labels that are there, the font size seems to be the same. Also the buttons seem to have the consistent look and feel. The next thing we can test is each label or text spelled correctly? So in order to test that, what you can do is you can select the entire text, copy it and paste it any word processor with spell checking functionality, and there you can test whether everything is spelled correctly or not. Or you can do a manual inspection and see if the labels and text is spelled correctly or not. The next thing we can test is each control aligned correctly? So we have the labels here, so they are aligned correctly, and we have these two text boxes, they are aligned correctly, the two buttons are aligned correctly, but maybe the drop down is not aligned correctly, so we can raise a request to have it aligned in line with the text boxes. Then we can test the user interface. Does the app show all the displayed data or not? So here we have the border of the application, and we can see all the text and the results or error messages that it shows are within the boundary, and we don't even have to scroll left or right or top to bottom, and we can see all the data. So this is working fine. Now, apart from all this testing that you can do with the requirements, so keep in mind that there are other resources also available, and you can take help of these resources, and with the help of these resources you can do further deeper testing of your application. So what are these resources? First of all, you can get a knowledge transfer. A knowledge transfer you can get from the business analyst or the product manager working on the project, so who is very much in sync with the requirements, because these are the roles that typically document the requirements or they own the requirements in the project. You can also talk to the project manager or the developers, because developers are the ones who take the requirements and implement those requirements into the application, so you can get a knowledge transfer from them. You can also get a knowledge transfer from the documents, such as high level business requirements or design documents, and based on the knowledge transfer you can further test your application. Another resource is the prior versions of the app, if available. So they are going to have some functionality, and you can work with those apps, you can explore those apps, and based on the knowledge that you gain with your exploration of the prior versions of the app, you can test the current version of the app, because usually whatever has already been implemented in prior versions should continue to work in the current version of the app also. There may be some older requirement specification documents of requirements that are already implemented in prior versions of the app, and you can use those requirements to design tests and test your app. You may also have access to past bug reports or customer complaints regarding the app, and especially the bug reports that have been fixed in the present version of the app, and you can test whether those bugs are actually fixed or not. There may be documents like the installation guide or release notes. They can contain information, and you can verify whether the information contained in the installation guide and release notes is correct, whether the app is working or according to them or not. Then you'll have your own domain or industry knowledge. So this is an app that we saw that we can call it a personal utility app, or we can put it in the transportation domain. So you may be testing an app that is in a different domain, such as finance or banking or insurance or healthcare. So based on your knowledge of that domain or industry, you can design useful tests and test your app. Depending on which industry the app is servicing, there may be laws or requirements that must be satisfied by the app. Regulatory requirements may be there, or there may be certain laws that the app has to satisfy, and you can look up those regulatory requirements and test the app according to those requirements. Finally, the most important tool that you have in your arsenal is your creativity. So you can explore the basics of the app, you can test the basics, you can test the functionality, then you can aim to generate some bugs in the app, try different test data, different test design techniques, different testing styles to find out whether there are any bugs in the app. So this is how we can test an app without having any requirements. So thank you for watching this video, and see you in the next one. Thank you.